get this here Silverado alignment started. All right, let's see what year this thing is. Gonna go ahead and do a quick alignment on it. This here is a 6 of 17 Chevrolet General Motors product, Silverado. Made out of real hurricanes and tornadoes. Whatever happened to that guy? A Mary King. Anyway, let's get this thing going. I gotta get it in the machine. I can do my rolling compensation. Oh, it's in park. That makes me sad. I didn't pull it on the rack. Now it should roll. We got options. That's gonna be interesting. All the same wheelbase, all two-wheel drive, all crew cab. So I gotta find these letters. That's probably gonna be on either the door tag or in the glove box. Let's see. Well, I don't see it on the door tag. Let's go look in the glove box. All right, one of these tags, something that's gonna start with a Q. Q-T-O, Q-D-O, there you go, or an R. I don't see anything with an R. Oh wait, there you go, R, rough R5A, R9M, Q-T-O, RC4, RD4. Alright, we're going to see which one of them lines up with my alignment machine. I might take a trip or two, let's see. Aha! Uh-huh. Q-T-O. Q-D-O. I like that one. That's what we're going to go with. Hopefully there isn't redundant ones. I doubt they'd be redundant suspension packages. They don't, usually one of those codes is it. If any of them match, that's what you have. So now I got to lock the steering, lock the brake pedal, and do the caster swing. Brakes are locked. Can't see the caster, so I got to stand on the rocker to do it. Luckily, it doesn't matter if you block the rear heads for the caster swing. Uh-oh. Oh, a little off to the right. Let's straighten that out. Put it in park now. Get my wheel nice and straight. 71,000 miles. Wheels dead straight right there. Lock that. See what our specs look like. Well, got a lot of tailwind in the front. It's about a degree and a half of tailwind. What's up, guys? All right, I lift this thing up. See what we need for tools. I'll use my adjustable wrench just for fun. I haven't used it in a little while. Customer with that Maserati wants us to, he hit something, damaged his intercooler, he wants us to put it on for 20 bucks. What a week, man. Yeah, 20 bucks, that's what he's offering. He said, how much labor? I said, you can't find anything in the labor guides because it's a Ferrari product. He said, there's nothing in the labor guides. They wanted to go to the dealer, like a Tesla. Well, he doesn't want to spend that much money. I know. Send him to the dealer. Is that mean? I don't know. I don't know. I like to get paid for my work. You know, that's just how it is. Like a plumber, no one expects a plumber to come to their house and fix the plumbing for free, but mechanics, you know, it'll take you a few minutes. Yeah, I know. I know. It's been an interesting week, guys. Hope I'm not venting too much, but trying to do what we can to get this tow right, get this alignment done. It's been like almost all day yesterday because of the robbery, kind of threw everyone off their pace and turned out to be like pretty much a waste of a day. So we gotta do what we can. I'm giving this about a third of a turn each time, like this. All right, that's how much it changes up there. All right, might do it. Now I'm gonna go past a little bit and then bring it back in, see if it does something with the other side. There you go. Just to play a little bit of play in the rack and pinion, and it's coming back to me. Let's do that. Boom. I locked that down and we're golden. I had to turn that was almost like three turns. It was way off. Like someone lifted this thing and never aligned it since they did that. You can see his tires, how chewed up they're getting on the outside. I mean, they're basically worn all the way across, but definitely favoring the inside. He's probably around 3 or 4 millimeters here and no millimeters, or 1 millimeter here. So there's definitely variation from inside to out. That's because there was so much toe in, the tire goes down the road like this. Now that I've got them straight, we're golden. We are golden. There's a little bit of caster variation. It's gonna go a little bit right probably. I'm gonna drive it and see how it tracks. With the big lift kit on there, it's probably never gonna be perfect, but you definitely wanna get it good. If I have to, I can just bump the caster a little bit and add some caster to the right front to get it closer to 3 degrees, and it'll be good, because it's got 5 degrees variation camber to the left. It always goes towards the most positive of camber and the most negative of caster, right? It's the least and the most M and S. That's how I remember it. It goes to the side with the most camber and the least caster. So one goes right and one goes left. It should track fairly straight. It might have a slight drip to the right, and if it does, I'm going to pull it back on the rack and add some caster. Let's see what happens. Chevy Silverado runs a little rough. You guys feel that in the camera? I'm going to turn his air on. I don't know why it was turned off, but some people still think the air doesn't shut off if you don't turn it off. Close the glove box, take this thing for a drive, make sure it doesn't drift to the right. Shouldn't be too bad. I'm sure it won't with these big giant tires on it. The only bigger problem is the tires are also worn out. So Maserati guy, he's leaving it with us. They told him 3 hours up front to put the intercooler in the right side. We're totally guessing on the labor. And of course he came back with a whole bunch of other parts he added. While you're in there, put on these other three parts. it's all predictable. So anyway, this Chevrolet truck has been lignamented. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I'm going to take it for a quick drive. Make sure it doesn't pull down this back road here. There's so much traffic, I'm not even going to try to fight that traffic. So luckily this truck sits like a four-wheel drive, even though it's two-wheel drive. We'll be able to get through these mud puddles and stuff, no problem. Make sure it goes straight on this road back here, and we'll be good to go. So I hope you guys got something from this video. Thanks for spending some time with me. Make sure you torque that like button at the bottom of your screen. It would really help out the channel. I'd appreciate it, especially the week I'm having. I could use some subscribes and some likes to cheer me up a little bit. So thanks, guys. I'll see you guys in the next video. You're awesome.